Warm weather and beautiful facilities make spring training in Florida any baseball player's dream. The 2016 Lyndon State baseball team spent a week in the Sunshine State living the life of a pro ball player. It may look like paradise for the boys, but the preparation to the start of the season began months ago. Located in northeastern Vermont, Lyndon State College faces the harsh cold of winter for several months a year. Snow normally covers Skip Pound Field until early April, which forces the team to train inside for the start of the season. During the fall and start of spring semester, the squad worked hard in the gym as the school's exercise science program hosted strength and conditioning workouts for the team.
10 minutes, we gotta roll!
Players worked out together 2 to 3 times a week, not only strengthening their bodies, but building team chemistry as well. The physical side of the game is not the only aspect the team trains, as the mental side of the game plays a large role for the student athletes. The Hornets hosted Personal Best, a mental training group from Massachusetts to campus, where the team learned how to be mentally prepared for the toughest mental game around. For the month of February, the team practiced inside Standard Gymnasium, using the facility as best as they could. Hitters would face live hitting inside of the batting cage, giving them the most game-like experience possible. With a week to go until the trip, season uniforms were given out. Individual pictures were taken, some going better than others.
Put your chest out a little bit.
Shut up, please.
Shut up.
When the team woke up on Tuesday morning, it was time to go. Over 30 players stuffed their luggage and gear into a school bus.
Yeah, we got a lot of bags left.
Yeah.
We got a lot.
Yeah.
You got a dead body in there?
No, it's 1980s hockey bag. It's collectible.
We should have taken Eli's little money.
See you in Florida.
It's our personal best packet. Really working on the mental game. You know, take being a good player and making him a great player.
Visualize, stay positive, leads to success.
You fall in love with the process and then the results follow.
Dev, you really need to work on your mental game, because I think it can take you from being a subpar college player
to just a below average college player.
So Dev, on behalf of the entire program, please step up your game.
Start training, you know. I really need this. Really, take me to the below average player.
You need to be that below average.
Guys, the airport is closed. We're driving the bus down.
Thank you.
After over a 2-hour drive, the bus arrived at Manchester Airport, where the team could leave the cold behind.
Here we go. Step one, when the state takes Florida. Let's go, baby.
The team boarded their flight, and after 3 hours of being high in the sky,
let's go. We're in Florida.
The team grabbed their stuff, headed to the vans, taking them to their condos. In the morning, the dream would become a reality. It was a beautiful Wednesday morning for baseball, but as a typical Florida day, large storms rolled through the area around midday. The team was scheduled to have their first outdoor practice at noon, but were pushed back to 3 because of the rain. During the early afternoon, some of the guys found a way to pass the time playing a game of Kringle created by junior Dan Pierce.
Would you be the first referee?
Do you want me to referee the Kringle game?
I would love you to referee the Kringle game because I have no idea how to play. And I have no idea how the rules go.
All right.
Fields were shut down for the day, but in typical LSC baseball fashion, that didn't stop them from getting better. Using an indoor hitting cage and a small field to the side, the team was able to practice just a day ahead of the opener, giving them a sense of how nice it was to play ball down south. The Hornets were under a day away from the season opener.
LSC Hornets!
On a windy day, the Hornets came ready to roll game one. It was a 0-0 score heading into the top of the fifth, where Lyndon would strike first. Reese Tangy did what he does best and drew a walk with the bases loaded, scoring Billy Johnson from third. That's all junior Jeff Williams would need, as he dominated his way to a complete game shutout, and the Hornets took their first game of the year 2-0.
All right, now that was behind us, though. We expect to do that, right?
Game two was a different story, as both teams put runs on the board. Freshman Johnny Boulay got the start on the mound, where Houghton would score early on, taking a 5-1 lead into the bottom of the fifth. And that's when the Hornets would rally. With the bases loaded, junior Billy Johnson singled up the middle, bringing home two runs to gut the deficit to one.
Get down! Catch a fight! Catch a fight!
Sophomore Ryan Cordero stepped up next and would beat out an infield single to score the tying run. Sophomore Andrew Whalen would come in relief in the seventh as he would pitch into the 10th inning before Houghton was able to add two runs and take the win. The Hornets would end day one with a split, heading into a tough matchup Friday with Concordia.
Another big day tomorrow, but I'm happy with the effort, fellas. And we're here, fellas. We're only going to get better. A lot of new guys, a lot of young guys got some good bats. Some guys got on the mound. A lot of experienced fellas. That's the name of the game. Keep getting better. Keep getting a little bit better every day.
The following day, Coach White called on another young arm to start the game, as sophomore Davis Geyer was on the bump. Geyer gave his team a great effort, going six innings, giving up two runs. In the top of the ninth, Concordia added three more runs, giving them a 5-0 lead into the bottom half of the inning. Hornets kept fighting.
Just have fun up at the plate. You guys look like you're pressing. Just get a couple of hits. We'll score some runs. Let's go.
Let's go. Let's go.
Have some fun. Have some fun.
Let's go. Hits on three. Hits on three. One, two, three. Hits.
Correa chops this one out to short. Takes a bad hop, gets past the shortstop into center field. Jake Torrain's going to score on this one. Cordero advances to first on single. Hornets now trailed by two runs, 5-3 in the bottom of the ninth.
They scrapped till the last out, but it was not enough, as the Hornets fell to 1-2 on the young season. On Saturday, freshman Ben Rollins would make his first collegiate start, as he would impress, though facing some adversity during the game.
I want to see just tailed right out.
Yeah,
it
went,
yeah,
he's gonna call it. That ball's, it's a strike.
No, 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 no.
If he's gonna give it to us, take advantage.
Rollins threw five shutout innings before Capital was able to plate the game-winning run in the bottom of the sixth. And the victory was sealed by something Lyndon normally does to its opponents.
He's going to make another move over to the first, and he fools Jourdain. Jourdain is now in a pickle. Shortstop's got the ball, and he's going to put that tag on his back, and it's going to end the game.
As the team headed back to the condos, they refocused, regrouped, and prepared for an off day. After a fun day in the sun, the team geared back up for a doubleheader on Monday with Milwaukee School of Engineering. Milwaukee was able to grab four runs off Williams in his second start, taking a 4-1 lead into the bottom of the fifth. Once again, the Hornets put together an inning that would change the game. With the bases loaded, junior Nate Stewart came to bat and would not disappoint. The Hornets were down one when freshman Michael Pena put the ball in play, forcing an error and scoring a run. Ben Rollins would pinch run for Pena, and a first and third play would allow Stewart to score from third, giving the Hornets the lead. That's all freshman Zach Johnson would need, and he shut the door for the next two innings, earning his first career save.
One more, let's go. Zach Johnson, hell of a job, baby. Yep. Comes in, he's confident, stays relaxed, he's calm, he feels the position, right? Does a great job, that's an excellent job, deep.
The Hornets would go on to lose game two, heading into their final doubleheader of the trip. The Hornets were taken down in game one against Hanover, but came ready to play competitive ball after some help from parents. The Tangy family gave the boys some midday fuel, as they provided bagels for the team. Several families traveled from afar to support their kids, coming from all over the East Coast.
Shane LaCroix, 29, gets pumped after a juice box.
After the snacks, the Hornets found themselves in a tough spot early, after having to deal with a 5-run deficit in the second inning. The Hornets were down by 3 runs in the bottom of the 7th, and that's when they got their bats going. The two leadoff men reached base after getting hit, which led to a pitching change by Hanover. Andre Easton Jr. would then reach on a fielder's choice, bringing 2 runs across the plate. Unfortunately, it was not enough. The comeback bid came up just short, and the Hornets lost their second game of the day, 5-4. Falling to 2-7 on the trip, the Hornets hoped their last day would be their best. The Hornets took the field for one last 9-inning contest against Lourdes University. Lourdes got on the scoreboard quickly, scoring 3 runs off Ben Rollins in the first inning. Rollins would settle down in the second, making it to the 5th inning without surrendering another run. The Hornets were able to add 2 runs in the 4th, but Lourdes came back to score 3 more in the 7th. Going into their final inning of their trip, the Hornets found themselves facing a 6-2 deficit.
We gotta come out with some intensity, some fire. Play with some heart, all right? We got something to prove today.
Let's go. Let's go.
Get down. After a Reese Tangy single to score a run,
read that.
Easton Jr. reached first on a fielding error by the first baseman. Devin Rollins would hit a deep fly ball to center, scoring Kevin Tufo and advancing Tangy to third. The Hornets were now down by just 1 run. That's when a Stewart ground ball would bring the tying run across and loaded the bases for Jordan. The newcomer had a chance to prove himself, and he delivered. A single to right field brought in 2 more runs to give the Hornets an 8-6 lead heading into the bottom half of the 9th.
Here together. One at a time, have some fun, do it together, man. Let's go.
The 6-run top half allowed Coach White to bring in Waylon to close the game. Coming from behind to capture their 3rd win of the season, the team was feeling
pumped. Take a win back to Vermont with us. I love it.
3 wins, fellas. Lyndon State baseball has never gotten 3 wins in a floor trip ever. You guys are making history, fellas. Making history. You did a great job. I love the toughness, fellas. Build off that toughness, especially you young guys. You see that stuff. You know, we've been through this. This is what we do. We deal with adversity all the time. Umpires, weather, doesn't matter. We are used to that stuff, fellas.
We came down here, we had fun, we took care of business. Back to Vermont, gentlemen. Yeah. Hornets on CLSC!
Hornets! Woo! Woo!
She put on the heels, put on the dress, put the address in the GPS.